Hi, good afternoon, dear students. Today I'll be where I left. In my last class, I covered what is DC generator, what is its working principle, what is the EMF equation of DC generator we have. So these are topics we covered in the last class. But today we'll start where we stopped in the last class. Today we'll continue with the types of generator. So what are the different types of generators we have? What is the working of each generator type? And how DC generators are classified? Based on what they are classified? And how many are there? Let us wait for one more minute. Training one by one. So after covering types of DC generators, I will be doing some problems, two or three problems on DC generator. Then we will move to DC motor. Again, its construction, its working principle. Then again, it is also having types of DC motors. Then again, two, three problems. Then we will finish one topic of fourth unit. Today we will finish DC motors also, if time permits. Anyway, this session is of 1.5 hour. Okay. We need Calci students today. Keep the Calci also along with you. We'll be solving the problems. Already I told you, keep on telling you in every session, without problems you cannot clear the subject. To pass the subject, you have to do the problems. After transformers, if any topics problems are easy, means that is this topic only, DC machines. If you know the formula, direct substitutions will be there. Simply write down the given values, put them in the formulas, calculate and write the answers. If you understand theory properly, you'll understand the formulas. If you know the formulas, you can solve the problem. You solve the problem, you will pass. So you can say Tata by 2 BW in first attempt only. Okay, we'll start now. Right. So types of DC generator. Before that, I'll just brush up what we covered in last class. In last class, we covered what is DC machine. DC machine is classified into two types: DC motor and DC generator. DC before that, machine is an machine means any electrical device where conversion will be taking place all the time. If any conversion is happening in any device, means that is called as machine. Either it is from electrical to mechanical or mechanical to electrical. So any conversion is happening, means that device is called as machine. So machine always, we can say that it's a converting device. So electrical energy can be converted to mechanical, or mechanical is converted into electrical. Yeah, you can know, you might have known laws of conservation of energy. Law of conservation of energy says that energy can neither be created nor be destroyed. It can be transferred from one form to another form. Okay, right. So here, mechanical to electrical we are converting means that is generator, and electrical to mechanical we are converting means that is motor. So together, machine is divided into two parts. So in that, we started DC generator. What is DC generator? It's a device which converts mechanical energy to electrical energy. What is the working principle? Started. So working principle of DC generator is again Faraday's laws. Faraday's law is the base for all the electrical machines. Without Faraday's laws, you cannot convert any electrical energy. So it is like base law. So what Faraday's law, what it says? If flux is cutting, means flux is changing. Once flux cuts, then only it will change. If that flux, change of flux is linking with the conductor, EMF induces. So in the DC generator also, that only we studied. It is consisting of majorly five parts: poles, armatures, commutator, yoke, field winding. Field windings, I told you, until unless you give the, you pass the current to the field winding, you cannot run the DC generator. Okay. Next, armature. Production of EMF takes place in armature only, and whatever the EMF induces in the armature, that is always AC. So we need DC because it is DC generator. So we need DC output. So that conversion of AC into DC takes place in commutator part, right? That also we studied in the last class. Then brushes, whatever the EMF converted into DC in the commutator, that will come out through the brushes. This is the function of brushes. So in the DC generator, what we did, EMF is induced in the armature. So armature is having conductors. So that armature will rotate and we produce the flux with the help of the field windings around the poles. Poles will produce the flux, and that flux will cut by armature conductors, because armature will be rotating, we give mechanical input. So as armature rotates, along with that armature conductor rotates. While rotating, those armature conductors come in contact with the flux produced by the poles, hence EMF induces. So that EMF through the brushes will come out to the load. This is we studied in DC generator. This is the working principle, Faraday's laws. Then whatever the amount of EMF induced, that also we derived there. What is the amount of EMF we induces in the generator? E is equal to phi n ZP divided by 60 A. Okay. This is the amount of EMF we induces in the generator. Right. Where phi is flux. Where phi is flux, right? N is speed, Z is conductors, I already told you. Next, P is what? P is number of poles. Okay, so A is parallel paths. So this much of amount of EMF we induced in the generator, and depending upon the armature winding, it is divided into two types. One is lap winding, another one is wave winding. If the given DC generator is lap, A is always P, A equal to P. If the given DC generator is wave winding, A is always 2. You should remember these two conditions. Okay, always in the problem, either it will be lap winding or wave winding. While solving the problem, you will understand this, don't worry. So today we'll start types of DC generator. Once again, before studying the types of DC generator, I will show you what is the symbolic representation of, okay, symbolic representation of DC generator. How DC generator we can represent symbolically? Symbolically, transformer we represent like this. Okay. Similarly, DC generator is represented like this. Okay, one circle along with two boxes. Inside this, you have to write G. Okay, G stands for generator. Similarly, if you are writing M inside, this represents motor. If you write G, it represents generator. So always, along with generator, we'll be showing one winding. Okay. So this is representation of generator. Here, if in motor, again, you'll show one field winding. Inside the circle, if you are writing M, that becomes DC motor. Inside the circle, if you are writing G, means this becomes DC generator. So this represents F1 and F2. Okay. And this represents A1 and A2. F1, F2, this is nothing but field winding. So always DC, either generator or motor, we represent with the field winding. Field winding we show separately, because until unless you give current to the field winding, DC generator will not be started. That is why field winding we always show separately. And remaining parts, you know, armature, these two terminals represents armature. So commutator, poles, commutator, poles, then armature, yoke, everything will be shown in this circle only. Everything we have to understand that it is inside the circle only. Only we take brushes outside. Why brushes outside? This also you know, because across the brushes only we take the output in the DC generator. Okay, so in the DC motor we give the input across the brushes. That is different case. While studying DC motor, you'll understand. Only the major parts we show in the DC generator. Field winding separately we show, because until unless we give the field, we excite the field winding, we cannot start the generator. Then brushes also we show separately, because through the brushes only we'll be taking the output. Then inside G, if you are written, it is generator. Inside M, it is written, it becomes motor. All your parts, armature, poles, commutator, yoke, everything will be shown inside the circuit only. It is understood. Only two terminals we take outside, A1 and A2. Okay. The generator. Keep this in mind. Now, field winding only we are showing separately outside. So depending upon the supply given to field winding, depending upon the supply given to field winding, it is classified into two types. Okay, it is depending upon the supply given to field winding, it is classified into two types majorly. This field winding is, you know, how we are giving the supply to this field winding. Depending upon that, it is classified into two types. What are those means? This is DC generator divided into two parts. One is separately excited. Another one is self-excited. These are the two types of DC generators. How they are classified? Depending upon the way in which supply is given to the field winding. How we are giving the supply to this field winding is divided into two types, separately excited and self-excited. Separately excited name itself indicates that we give the supply to the field winding separately. Means using some external device, we are giving the supply to the field winding. That is why that is called a separately excited. Self-excited means supply to the field winding will give from the generator itself. From the generator itself, if you give the supply to the field winding, that becomes self-excited. If we are giving any external, we are using any external source like battery source or something, through that if you are giving the supply to the field winding, means that is called as self-excited. Now see what happens in self-excited DC generator. So depending upon the way in which we are giving the supply to the field winding is classified into two types, separately excited and self-excited. First we'll study separately excited. Okay, so separately excited DC generator. So in this type of generator, we have to give the supply to the field winding separately using some external device. How it looks like? What is this circuit diagram here? So first, field winding. We have to show field winding separately to draw the DC generator. Then again, this is generator. Okay. Then across the generator only we'll take the output. So this is brushes. So across this we'll be taking output. So this you can say load. Right, now this is the field winding to the field winding, we are giving the supply using external battery source. So this is the diagram for this is input voltage. So this is the diagram for separately excited. So in the generator only, inside the generator, where EMF will induce inside the armature. So whatever the EMF induced, that is where denoting as EG. So this is generated EMF inside the generator. So EG, after EMF induces, what current flows across the armature? IA current, because it is closed circuit. Once EG is generated, EMF is induced, current starts flowing across the armature. So that current, you can say that IA, and across the output or across the load, IL current will flow, right? If armature current is flowing across the armature, means it will be having its resistance also, which protects the armature. That you can say RA. RA is the armature resistance. IA is the armature current. These all will flow in the armature. Before that, these all are happening because of current given to the field winding. Until unless we give the supply to the field winding, this process won't exist. Because once we give the supply to field winding, then only it produces the flux. That flux cut by these conductors, then only EMF induces EG. So we need to give a supply. Separately we are giving the EMF. So this is field winding. So across field winding, the current which flows is nothing but field current. So IF current, once we apply input voltage, IF current flows across the field winding, right? So after the current flows across field winding, EMF is generating inside the armature. Because of this EMF generated, current across the armature starts flowing. That current is IA, and across the load current you will get IL current. So these are the different changes taking place in the separately excited DC generator. So here you will be taking output voltage, we can say across the load, whatever the voltage you will take, that will be your output voltage. So here IF is what? Field current. IF is called as field current. Then IA is armature current. Next, IL is load current, or you can say output current. You draw this diagram for better understanding. I'll give you 30 seconds time, or you understand this carefully. See the diagram. If you have any doubt, make a note of it. Later on we'll discuss. Okay, so see here, this is completely one closed circuit. So whatever the current which is flowing in the armature, same current will be available across the load current. With this diagram we'll generate some relations. What are those? See here one by one. So in this generator, whatever the current flowing in the armature, same current will flow across the load also. Therefore IA will be equal to IL, and here you can say that output voltage, you can say VT. VT is also called as terminal voltage, and VT will be equal to what? Output voltage is always less than the generated voltage, because while current flowing through the armature, some amount of current drops here because of the armature resistance, and some amount of current drops across the brushes also. Okay, so there will be voltage drop, losses takes place. That is why output voltage is always less than generated voltage. So generated voltage is EG minus IA RA. So this becomes your voltage equation. How we got this, I will tell you with the help of equation. So see there, forget about this. So here, what are the different types of voltages taking place in this generator? Tell me. First EG, then again plus IA RA also, right? I into R is also one type of voltage. This is generated voltage, This is voltage drop across the armature. Then some amount of voltage drops across brushes also, plus VB also. You can apply KVL to this loop. All the voltages should be equal to zero. This is EG, generator voltage is one voltage. Some amount of voltage is dropped the brushes while passing through. That you can say VB. When current, armature will have some amount of resistance to save the armature conductors also. So IARA is also one voltage. And here, once you come here, here also VT, terminal voltage, output voltage. So all these voltages will be equal to zero. Therefore, I want output voltage, VT. VT is equal to what? EG minus IA RA minus VB. So usually brushes, the usually the whatever the drop takes across the brushes is very, very less. Hence, we neglect this all the time. Okay. The drop is very less since we neglect that. So the given equation becomes VT is equal to EG minus IA RA. So these are the different relations we generate in separately excited DC generator. Okay. So one, in separately excited generator, whatever the current flowing in the armature, same current will flow across the load also. IA will be equal to IL. This is one relation we generate. And the output voltage is always less than the generated voltage because of the drops, because of the losses takes place in the generator. Those, these two equations you have to remember to solve the problem. Then next, see here, separately excited field winding. To the field winding, we're giving supply externally using some battery sources. We are giving the supply. That is why it is named as separately excited field winding. We are exciting separately using battery source. That is why it is separately excited DC generator. In this type of generator, armature current is always equal to load current, and terminal voltage is equal to generator voltage minus IA into RA. Right. Next. Wait, I am checking with the camera clarity. Now it is okay, no? Next, self-excited DC generator. Self-excited DC generator. In the name itself, you have answer. Self means on its own. So field winding is getting supply from the generator terminal itself. From the generator only, we are giving the supply. From the generator itself. That is why it is called as self-excited. So depending upon that, it is classified into three types. Self-excited generator is classified into three types. One is DC series generator. Series generator. Then second one is shunt generator. Third one is compound generator. Okay, so depending upon the excitation given to the field winding, self-excited generator is classified into three types: series generator, shunt generator, and compound. Compound again classified into two types: long shunt and short shunt. This is the classification structure of self excited generator. It is classified, self excited generator is classified into three types: series generator, shunt generator, and compound generator. Compound is again classified into two types: long shunt and short shunt. So I am telling you that in the self excited generator, we give the supply to the field winding from the generator itself. Now next question, these three are classified, no? Now how these three are classified means, depending upon the way in which we connect the field winding across the armature. This is the armature part, you can say. Armature, commutator, motor, everything comes inside this circle only. Here onwards, I will call this circle as armature. To this portion, how this field winding is connected? Depending upon the position, okay? Depending upon the connection in which these two are connected, it is classified into three types: series, shunt, and compound. Okay? You can see first. Once I draw first type, you'll understand. Voice is clear? Are I am shouting here from last 4-5 days. I am shouting only. So first we'll see. Series generator. DC series generator. I am not writing DC because we are studying DC only. So I will not write this, don't get confused. So DC series generator. So I told you how field winding is connected with the armature. Depending upon that, it is classified into three types: series, shunt, and compound. How field winding is connected in series, you see. So what is the name? Series. So it means field winding will be connected in series with the armature of the generator. That is why it is called as series generator. See the diagram. This is field winding. First we'll draw armature. So this is generator. These are the brushes. Okay. So across the armature, I am connecting field winding in series. So across this, I am taking output. So this is load. So whatever the voltage available across load will be VT. It is nothing but terminal voltage. So this is which field? Series. That is why it is named as RSC. Okay. IS. As of now, it is series field winding. So here I have not shown any external devices because this is type of self excited. From the armature itself, I am giving the supply to the series field winding. This we can say A1 and this we can say A2. Now you understood, na? A1, A2 in the lab we mentioned F1, F2 and A1, A2. Until unless you give the supply to F1, F2, this you can say F1 and this you can say F2. So this is F1 and F2, field winding terminals. I1 and A2 is armature terminals. So here across the armature, field winding is connected in series. That is why it is called a series generator. And it is self-excited. From this armature only we are giving the supply to the field winding. From this only we are giving the supply. So first what happens? You may get a doubt that, sir, without giving the supply to the field winding externally, how we generate the flux, sir? To generate the EMF, we need flux. So to produce the flux, we have to give the supply to the field winding. So here we are not giving any supply. Then how can we get the current in the armature, sir? That doubt you can get. So for that also, there is one property exists in the magnet. magnet will be having one property that is called as residual magnetism. So residual magnetism is the property of the magnet which stores some amount of magnetic flux in it, even though if you don't give the supply. Likewise, I will give you an example. Think that fan is rotating. After some time, if you switch off the fan, immediately it will not stop. It will take some time till all the energy gets exhausted, all the energy minimizes to zero, then only fan will stop. After switching off, due to its relative motion, it will take some time to come to completely rest. Similarly, in magnets also, there will be some property, there is some property exists. That property is called a residual magnetism. So if you give the supply or don't give the supply, there will be always some amount of flux present in the magnet. So here we are using poles as a magnetic materials. Okay, so all poles will be having some amount of flux stored in it. So that small flux, as soon as we rotate the shaft, armature conductor rotates. So those armature conductors will cut those small flux present in the poles because of residual magnetism. So that flux cut by the armature conductors, which results in small amount of EMF inducers. Okay, that EMF again will give back to field winding only we are giving. From the armature again we are giving to field winding only. So that small amount of EMF again flows through the field winding only. Again field winding will get more current, some extra current that produces extra flux. Again that extra flux is cut by the conductors, again more amount of EMF induced, again that EMF we are giving to field winding. So in this process, EMF induced and the amount of current flows across the field winding increases. So building up of the EMF takes place here. So this process is also called as building up of EMF. So here step by step we are increasing the amount of flux production, hence we are increasing the amount of EMF induced inside the generator. So this is how we give the supply to the field winding from the generator itself or from the armature itself. Okay, so that is why it is called as self-excited. In this way we make the generator self. So wherever, everywhere, whatever the generators we use everywhere, they all are self-excited only. Separately excited is for only understanding purpose. Okay, so everywhere we use self-excited only. Okay, otherwise there is no point in developing the generator. To generate the current, if we require current, what is the use of designing the generator, right? So everywhere inside the generator we use the magnets, those magnetic poles which have high residual magnetism. You might be knowing that magnet is divided into two types. One is permanent magnet, another one is temporary magnet. You know this, right? So temporary is nothing but electromagnets. We make them magnet temporarily by passing the current. Permanent magnet is that magnet where if you give supply or don't give supply, flux will be there all the time. So the permanent magnets only we use inside the generators, right? For more clarity, wherever large amount of voltage to be induced, there we use permanent magnets. Okay. Now what are the changes takes place here? What are the different relations we will be able to generate in the series generator C one by one? First, what is happening? After giving the supply to the field winding from the armature, EMF is generating EG. EG will generate. Because of EG, IA current will flow from here. IA RA will be always there. IA is there means along with IA RA will be there. And make it understand. Then once IA current starts flows across the field winding, this is series field winding. That is why series current will flow across the field winding. That is why I am giving the name as ISC. ISC stands for across the series field winding. And it will be having the resistance. we can say it as RSC, right? This is RS. So these are the, and across load, IL current will be flowing. Now from the above diagram, we can say that IA is equal to completely everything is series only. Therefore, whatever the current flowing across the armature, same will be flowing across ISC, same will be flowing across load. So IA will be equal to ISC and IL. What will be the voltage equation? VT is equal to generated voltage minus IARA minus this one, ISC into RSC minus VB. So this is the voltage equation we get. VB all the time will be very small, hence we neglect this. This can also be written as EG minus IA into RA plus RSC. Can we write like this? Because IA is equal to ISC, right? Because IA is equal to ISC. You can write IL also. Anything you can write. It is up to you. If you know this relation and this equation, you can write a equation in any manner you want depending upon the need in the problem, right? So VD is equal to EG minus IA into RA plus RSC, where RA is armature resistance, RSC is field winding resistance, series field winding. IA is armature current, EG is generated voltage, VT is output voltage, right? So these are the relations we generate in series field winding. So what will be the power equation? Generally power is equal to V into I. So here power is always output power only we need. Output, what is the voltage available across the output? VT. What is the current flowing across the output? IL. So VT into IL is your power equation, output power. So what will be the input power equation? Input means where EMF is generating? Here. So here what is the voltage available? EG. What is the current flowing? IA. Right? So this is the, it's not ISC, it's not ISC, it is ISE. E means, SE stands for series, because we are using series field winding. ISE it is, not ISC. Okay, don't get confused. So this is about series field winding. Then next, shunt field winding. Second one is shunt generator. This is shunt generator. So again, name itself is telling that generator is shunt type. Shunt means parallel connection. Any parallel connection is called as shunt. This is technical word. In electrical energy we use, in engineering we use shunt, nothing but parallel connection. Parallel connection we called as shunt. So here this is again armature of the motor. G stands for generator, right? So across generator, this is output. Across the output, what is the voltage available? VT. And across the output, IL current will flow all the time. So this is brushes. Now shunt generator, we have to connect the field winding across the armature in parallel. See how we are connecting here. So this is the shunt field winding I have connected in parallel. these two are in parallel. That is why it is called as shunt. So general field winding is connected across the armature in parallel connection. That is why it is called as shunt generator. Now again, it is also self-excited type. From the armature itself, we give the supply to this field winding. So EG will generate. After EG generates, IA will flow across the armature. So one current will give to field. It is shunt field. That is why you can call it as ISH. SH stands for shunt. Shunt current, which is flowing in the field winding. ISH. And here it will be having resistance called RSH. I'll use red pens. Okay. So one current is flowing across load, that is IL. So same I have shown here also IL. So these are the different types of currents and voltages exist in the IA means always there will be RA. Okay, ISH, RSH. Next, what are the equations we can generate here? Once IA starts flowing, it is dividing into two parts. One is ISH, another one is IL. So IA here will be equal to ISH plus IL. You can use Kirchhoff's current law. Sum of incoming currents is equal to sum of outgoing currents. Across this node, IA is incoming, ISH is outgoing, and IL is also outgoing. So IA is incoming, it is equal to ISH plus IL. Okay. So IA will be equal to ISH plus IL. This is the current generation, the current relation. Then next, what will be the terminal voltage? VT is equal to EG minus IA into RA minus ISH into RSH. Okay. Sorry, this will not come into picture because across the output we are calculating. This is input, it will not come under output part. So VG will be equal to EG minus IARA. Next, what is the value of ISH? If I want to find out ISH, ISH is the current flowing in the field winding. So what will be the, generally current is equal to V by R, but I want shunt current. This field winding, what is the voltage available across this? What is the voltage available across this terminal? Here also same voltage will be there because it is parallel connection. In parallel voltage will be same. Therefore ISH is equal to VT divided by its resistance is RSH. So this is the equation of shunt current. Okay. This is the equation of shunt current. And tell me what is the old power equation, output power. P output is equal to, P output is equal to, I'll wait for 10 seconds. Let us see who will answer this. Output power equation. Output power equation will be, see the diagram, tell me the output power equation. Generally power is voltage into current, so I want output power. So it will be, output power will be output power will be, what is the voltage available across the output? VT. What is the current flowing across the output? IL. So this is your output power equation, right? So these are the voltages, or these are the relations we generate in the shunt generator, right? You can have a look. First is IA will be equal to ISH plus IL in DC generator. Then VT will be equal to EG minus IARA. ISH will be equal to VT divided by RSH. Output power will be equal to VT into IL. Okay. IL, right? Next, Third one is compound generator. Third one is compound generator. In this generator, compound generator is divided into two types. I already told you, one is long shunt, another one is short shunt. Compound generator, long shunt. First of all, what is compound? We have to understand compound generator. In this generator we use both combination of series field winding and shunt field winding, that is called as compound. If you are using both in the diagram, that is nothing but compound. In this compound generator we use both series and shunt, combination of both we use, and depending upon the combinations it is divided into two types, long shunt and short shunt. So in long shunt generator, shunt field winding we are connecting in long way. How we are connecting that in long way? See here. First of all, compound means combination of both series and shunt will be there. In that, if shunt field winding we are connecting long along the armature, means it is long shunt. How we connect? See here. Once I draw the diagram, we'll understand. In the long shunt, first this is motor, sorry, generator along with the brushes I'm showing. Next we are connecting output, and across the output I'm taking the load. Whatever the output available, whatever the voltage available across the load, we can say that terminal voltage. And always across the output, the current which will be flowing is called as load current. Next is, I told you compound means combination of both series and shunt. Compound means combination of both series plus shunt. Both winding we use inside the diagram. That is why it is called as compound. Depending upon how shunt is used, it is divided into two types, long and short. So in this long shunt, we are connecting shunt field winding in the long manner. Very long. How, see here? This is IS series field winding. This is the diagram series field winding. Because armature of the generator I have connected in series. To this combination, if shunt field winding is connected parallelly, then it is called as long shunt. So this is the diagram of long shunt. If the shunt field winding is connected in parallel across the complete series combination of armature and field winding, then it is called long shunt. In long shunt generator, shunt field winding is connected in parallel across the series generator, or you can say shunt field winding is completely connected in parallel with the series field winding as well as the armature. That is why it is called as long shunt. So here what happens, EG will generate inside the armature. After EG generates, IF flows across the armature. Once armature current flows across the series field winding, this is the RSC. So here ISC will flow across series field winding. ISC will flow across the armature. IA will flow. Series field winding will be having RSC, its resistance, and IA also will be having its resistance RA. Right. So when it comes to here, one will go to field winding. So field winding means shunt field winding. It is, that is why ISH.
Across series field winding, ISC will flow. Across shunt field winding, ISH will flow. Right? So one will go to field winding, another will go to load. That is called as load current. So these are the different. So these are the different currents which will flow in the DC generator of long shunt. Now let us see what are the generation, what are the relations we can generate. So here in the diagram, IA is dividing into again 2. What is that? One is going to ISH, another one is going to load current. So IA will be equal to ISH plus IL, but IA is equal to ISC. These two are in series, therefore IA current will be equal to ISC, but IA is equal to ISC. Therefore, equation we can write as ISC is equal to ISH plus IL. Like this also we can write, because IA is equal to ISC. Now what will be the equation, terminal voltage equation, VT for this diagram. VT is equal to in your path towards the output, how many types of voltages come across, those all we have to write. So VT is equal to, first is EG, then minus, this is voltage drop, IARA, this is also voltage drop, minus ISC into RSC, minus VT. So this is the voltage equation. This further you can write as EG is minus IA is equal to what? ISC. So IA into RA plus VT I have already written left side only. So minus RA into RSC. Okay. So this is the generation. This is the relation we will get. Okay. Now what will be the, this is RSH. Now tell me, what is the equation for ISH? Again, ISH will be equal to same, VT divided by RSH. This is correct for compound, long shunt compound. ISH, now here, in between these two parallel combinations, this is also there. That is why ISH equation you will get terminal voltage, this voltage minus this voltage, sorry, this plus, this is a extra we are adding here, no? So VT plus ISC RSC divided by RSH. Okay, this will be the equation for shunt current. So these are the relations we generate in long shunt. The voltage across this will be, the voltage available across this will be this voltage plus this voltage. Okay. Right. Next is last one, compound generator last one is short shunt. So here again name itself tell you how to connect field winding, how to connect shunt field winding across the armature. So long means completely we have connected, in short we have to take both series field winding, the series field winding, across the series field winding, this is load. So across the series field winding I am connecting shunt field winding will be short here. Okay, like this. So So shunt field winding will be connected in parallel with only armature part, not to the complete series generator. So here field winding is connected across complete series generator, completely long. But here shunt field winding is connected only across the armature. I have reduced the length, I have shortened the length of the field winding. That is why it is called as short shunt. Okay, that is why it is called as short shunt. So in short shunt, shunt field winding is connected only across the armature. So whatever the current, this is brushes. So here Eg will generate, because of the Eg, Ia will flow, and this Ia current will flow across shunt field winding as ISH, this is RSH, and one current will flow across here, this is series field winding, so here ISC will flow, then here load current will flow, here terminal voltage VT will get, right? Okay, power equation for all the types of generators remains same only. For the understanding purpose, I have written in two cases. Okay, for all the DC generators, power equation remains same, because what is the power equation? Voltage into current. So in all the generators, you can see what is the voltage and current available across the output? VT and IL only. Therefore, power output power is equal to VT into IL. What is the input power? Where electricity is generating? In the armature only, right? So what is generating in all the cases? Eg. What is the current flowing in the armature? Ia. So input power equation is Eg into Ia. Output power equation will be Vt into IL in all cases. Okay, it will not change. Right. Now tell me the relations for this diagram. I will tell you that you have understood or not. So here, tell me current equation. Ia is equal to, Ia current is coming out, one is going to field winding, another one is going to series field winding. So it will be what? Ia is equal to, tell me the equation. Ia is equal to, already drawn four diagrams. Use Kirchhoff's laws, use electrical fundamentals. Ia is coming out, Ia is flowing here, one is going to ISH, another one is going to series field winding. Therefore Ia is equal to what? Ia is equal to ISH plus ISC. Okay, ISH plus ISC, but ISC is equal to what? These two are in series, but ISC is equal to, but ISC is equal to IL. Therefore we can write Ia is equal to ISH plus IL. Okay, ISC is equal to IL. You can write this equation as like this also. Therefore, Ia is equal to ISH plus IL is the equation we generate here. Next, what is the voltage equation? Terminal voltage, this output voltage equation. Vt is equal to Vt is equal to Eg minus IaRa minus ISC into RSC minus ISC into RSC, which is equal to Eg minus Ia into Ra plus RSC. Here Ia is equal to Ia only, but in case of compound generators long shunt, Ia will be equal to what? ISC. Okay, these are the differences. Here Ia is equal to ISC, but not here. Here ISC is equal to IL, here ISC is equal to Ia. These are the differences you have to remember while solving the problems. to remember these formulas, you have to know, remember the diagram, because if you know the diagram, you can easily write the formulas. Whenever any problem is given in the exam, first read the problem and find out that which type of generator it is. That say if that particular type of generator circuit diagram you draw somewhere in the corner, if you draw the diagram, you can write these formulas. Write the formulas, then start solving the problem. It will be easy always. Okay, this is how we have to solve the problems. Then what will be the current equation? ISH will be, in this case, IHS is equal to VT plus ISC RS divided by RSH. But here ISH will be this voltage minus this voltage. But here this voltage plus this voltage, because it is completely connected to here. But here it is only connected to half portion. From this voltage, if you remove this voltage, you will get this voltage. Okay. Therefore, ISH is equal to VT minus ISC RSC divided by RSH. Or this you can also write as across this, like this also you can write terminal voltage for short shunt. Note down this. Sorry, there is a small correction. For this, all three are in parallel, no? Therefore, ISH will be same only, VT divided by RSH. Sorry, make a correction. So here, these all three are in parallel only. So whatever is the voltage available here, same will be available here. So here, ISH will be V by RSH. Here, voltage across this will be this plus this only. Okay, this plus this. Please make a correction, small correction here. Okay. Note down these formulas, they are important. Until unless you know the formula. Difference between long shunt and short shunt, here only, just now I told you, here completely we connect the shunt field winding, will connect completely across the combination of field winding and armature. Here only across the armature we are connecting the shunt field winding. By seeing the diagram also, you only can able to identify the difference. Okay. This is about the types of DC generators. We'll solve 2 or 3 problems. We'll finish this topic. We'll solve 2 problems. Now there are so many formulas you have to remember. To remember the formula, you should know the circuit diagrams. If you know the circuit diagrams, easily you can solve the problems. First, we'll solve the problem. One problem on EMF equation. First problem you write down. 6 pole lap wound DC generator. First problem. 6 pole lap wound. 6 pole lap wound DC generator. 6 pole lap wound DC generator has 600 conductors. Has 600 conductors. 6 pole lap wound DC generator has 600 conductors on its armature. 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 The flux per pole is 0.02 Weber. 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 Calculate number 1. Calculate number 1. Speed at which generator. Calculate the speed at which the generator must be running to generate 300 volt. At which generator must be running. Must be running to generate 300 volt. Must be running to generate 300 volt. Second, what would be the speed? Second one. What would be the speed if the generator were wave connected? So this is the question. This is the question. Read out the question carefully. Read out the problem and write down the given values. What are the values they are given? DC generators are used in various applications depending upon the types they use in so many applications. Okay, they are classified into four types. No, different types of DC generators used in different applications. Shunt DC generators used in battery charging devices. Separately, shunt generators used in battery charging devices. To charge the battery, we use shunt generators. Then compound generators are used to maintain the constant voltage at various industries. Wherever we need constant voltage now, there we go for compound generators. Then wherever we need constant current, there we go for series DC generators, because in series generators current is same across all the terminals. So wherever we require constant current, there we use series generators. Wherever we require constant voltage, we use compound. And to charge the battery, we use shunt generators. Shunt generators are used to charge the batteries. Okay, these are the different types of applications of DC generators. Separately excited is used very rarely. It is used very rarely, okay. For the speed regulation, to increase the, to regulate the speed, we use separately excited DC generators and all. Okay, so we'll solve this problem. So what is given in this problem? First, write down, identify which kind of generator it is. 6-pole lap owned DC generator. This is lap owned DC generator, has 600 conductors. Okay, so P is equal to how much? 6. Poles means nothing but P. Number of poles are 6. Okay, and it is, I told you, armature is having two types of windings, lap winding and wave winding. So this is, he has given lap winding. In lap winding, you already, you know that A is always P. A is equal to P. In that case, A is also 6. Right? A is also 6. Then what else he has given? Apart from this, 600 conductors he has given. Conductors are denoted with Z. Z is equal to how much? 600. Z is equal to 600. In electro plating, we need constant current. Okay, current should be constant. So there we use which generator? Series generators, right? Okay, application nothing, there's 4 points are there. You need to, if I anyway, I will be sharing you the notes. From the notes you can read out the applications. It's not big deal. If you understand working principle, it is automatically okay. Z is equal to how much? 600, right? So Z is equal to 600. Then what is this? Flux per pole is 0.02. Therefore, phi is equal to 0.02 Weber. So these are the given values. So what is asked you to find out? Find out the speed at which generator must be running to give 300 volt. 300 volt is what? Eg is equal to 300. He has given. To generate 300 volt, what is the speed we require? This is first point he has asked. So speed, to identify the speed, what is the equation? So write down EMF equation. What is the EMF equation? Eg is equal to phi n Zp divided by 60. Using this equation we have to find out the speed. Write down this equation in terms of speed. So n is equal to 60 A into Eg, 60 A into Eg divided by phi Zp. 60 A is how much? 6. Then Eg is 300 divided by phi is 0.02. Z is 600. Again P is 6. This get cancels. These two zero get cancels. 3 1 3 2 2 1 2 30. Then how much? What will be the speed? 0.02 divided by 30 means how much? You remove this decimal, you add two zeros. So how much it is? 1500. So N will be 1500 RPM. So this is the speed to generate 300 voltage. So we identify speed. First one is speed 1500. What he has given in the second point? What would be the speed if the generator were wave connected? So if the generator is lap connected, what is the speed he asked? If this generator is wave connected, what will be the speed he is asked in the second point? So for wave connected, what is this value of A? For wave connected, you know A is equal to always 2. Now what will be the speed? You calculate and tell me. Everything will be same. In place of A, we have to substitute 2. Speed equation is same. N is equal to 60A into EG divided by 5ZP. What is the answer? Say if you have gone mad, 64 lakh, 6 crore 48 lakh speed which machine will rotate? Substitute and tell me. Don't give stupid answers here. Okay? With lot of problems, lot of the problems we have to upload to record one live session class. We are struggling a lot. We don't have network here. We don't have power here. I am staying in my native place. Here 24 hour power supply will not be there. Okay? So how I am managing to give the to record the live videos, how much struggle I am doing here, you don't know. Simply don't do comment here stupid answers and all. Whatever the things related to the lecture, that only you do here. Okay? Understand the problems of faculties also. How we are charging the mobile, how we are saving the data, we only know that problem. We only know that headache. If you are not understanding anything, that you ask me here. It applies to every student. So in wave connected winding, speed will be 500 RPM. Okay. So this is the answer for wave connected. Right. So this is the problem. For problems only, I'll keep separate session. For DC motor and generator, one session will keep only for problems. In the next class, today I'll conclude here only. Today we covered types of DC generators. What are the different types of DC generators available? How they are classified, what are the different relations we get for the different types of DC generators, what are the applications of the DC generators, that also we covered. Different DC generators are having different applications depending upon their characteristics, right? Wherever we require constant voltage, there we use compound generators. Where we require constant current, there we use series generators. And to charge the batteries, for charging purpose we use shunt generators. Okay, I hope you understood the class. I hope you understood today's lecture. So we'll meet in the next section. There we will cover DC motor, work is construction, its working, its types, and some problems. So I'll be signing off. Bye, take care, stay safe. Stay at home, stay healthy. Bye bye.